What's up, everybody, and welcome to another segment of The Matrix with your boy Prime. Glad y'all can officially join me. I'm going to talk about these ratings and the breakdowns and the actual categories on how EA has, from the past couple of years, has truly regressed when it comes down to their rating system and how they try to condense it and try, in my estimation, how I feel is that they try to get lazy with it. Now, this is NBA Elite 11, all right? And in NBA Elite 11, they had some categories that were very, very good, but also intriguing. Now, I've been saying this for the past couple of years, and then at the end of this video, I will actually have the categories listed when everything, this is from level 7, level 8, level 9, and where it was so deep, where the ratings and where these need to come back into fruition and where things of basketball needs to come into play. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to showcase all this and y'all will see how the regression process has really come into play. And now I'm only going to showcase a couple of the games. I'm going to showcase these games, and then once I showcase them, y'all will actually see what I mean by art of the state of regression when it comes down to this. Now, I'm going to show y'all NBA Elite 11, but then I'm going to show you NBA Live 10, and then I'm going to show you what was in 07, 08, and 09, all right? And all these ratings started in NBA Live 07, which is probably the only bright spot, well, one of the five bright spots that was in NBA Live 07, because NBA Live 07 was so bad. But I will showcase that so y'all can actually see what I mean by the elements of regression. So let's go ahead and take a look at this at NBA Elite 11. So you got the overall. So I'm just going to showcase Kevin Durant. And y'all seeing that that's the USA team. The USA team. You know what? I'm going to do it like this. Let me do it like this. Let me go to the Oklahoma City Thunder. I'm not going to do the USA team. I'll go to the actual Oklahoma City Thunder. And y'all can actually see them there. So let me go ahead. No, I'm going the wrong way. Let me go to the Oklahoma City Thunder so y'all can see it in that way. And I don't want y'all to know. There we go. All right. So y'all can see it in this format. All right. So now we have speed. So it says the maximum for running speed. Now, the way they have it described here is that that's just the actual speed. And then you have acceleration. Ability to get up to speed quickly and change directions, make moves at high speeds. Now, the good thing about this, ladies and gentlemen, is that in NBA Elite 11, it is extremely displayed in this game when it comes down to the speed and the acceleration. Now, mind you, NBA Elite 11 didn't have a turbo button. The players automatically did it because of their awareness on the court, or how their moves were executed and played out in the game. So you see speed and you see acceleration. Now vertical, the maximum height jump. Now the thing that I'm still testing in on this game is that some players can jump higher than others and you really can't see it. Now the more that I play it, some of the things that I do see, because some guys, and you know Kevin Durant is already tall, but you can actually see the difference in height and how players jump, which is a real, real good thing. Conditioning, meaning is that the ability to resist fatigue. Now, some players are going to get more fatigued than others in this game. And the more that you play it, you really can tell when players are getting fatigued in the game because they do not move as fast in the game. They don't really showcase it fully like 2K does. And the way they should do, you know, when players really, really start getting slow, you see the Gatorade, they start to topple over, they start to bend down a lot. So they really don't show that. That's one thing that's a flaw in EA Sports and what they do when it comes down to the fatigue. They need to do a little bit more emphasis in showcasing fatigue on the court. So that way you actually see how the players get fatigued. Strength. Now, physical strength. Now, this is really presented in this game a lot because of the physics that is in Elite 11. And the physics in this game is really presented a lot, and you can really tell strength when it comes down, because there's not a lot of two-man animation sequences in here, but there is a lot of physics in the game that is presented. So if your guy does not have a lot of strength in the game, you're going to see it. Defensive rebounding. Now, how I look at it like this, and y'all going to see another thing, and I'll break it down. There is two rebounding. There are two rebounding ratings that's in this game. When you go to the new NBA Live games, and I said it before, they basically conjoin rebounding into one category, and you really cannot find out what do you mean. Are they better on the defensive rebounds? Are they better on offensive reboundings? All they have is rebounding in the new titles, meaning as in 16, 18, and 19, which really isn't good. And that's why I say they regress when it comes down to really mapping out and showcasing the rating system in their game, in the product. Perimeter defense. Now, perimeter defense is really shown in this game because you really have to really use footwork in this game. So perimeter defense, there's some guys that can play defense better than others, and it really shows in this game. Blocks, you can block shots, and some guys can get off their feet faster than others when you're blocking shots. So if you know how to play manual defense in the game, the ratings does match up in this game. Steals, ability to steal the ball from an offensive player. Now stealing, I know there's a video that I have in this particular list that I show, but in when it comes down to steals, you have all ways on how to steal the ball. There is a little tutorial that I do have in there, and it shows you all the actual swipes and what you can do with steals with the right thumbsticks, but it is based on ratings, which is a good thing. Defensive posts. Ability to move quickly and maintain defense position in the post. This is good too because they have certain good elements of defense defensively in the game, but it takes time and practice to really get the defense going. Like I said again, it's in that actual video that I show, but the ratings are respected in this game. Outside shooting likelihood, and it's going to go hand in hand with this because a lot of people get mixed up and they don't understand this, and this is why I say this category needs to be re-implemented back into the game. Likelihood means how many threes they are more likely to take. All right, so it's an 80% chance that he's going to take a three a lot of times. This right here, the outside shooting, that means his percentage on how good he's going to make the shot. This is the likelihood of how many times he will actually take the shot, and this is the likelihood of him making it. All right, so that is what those mean, and I wish they put those back in. Same thing with the mid-range shot. As you see, the likelihood of him taking a mid-range shot is a little bit more than him taking a three. And y'all know Durant is a very, very good efficient scorer when it gets down to the mid-range. And he's 90% in mid-range. So he's going to make these a little bit more better than he would a three. So like I say, he's a deadly weapon. All right? It's the same thing. It goes hand in hand with the three. Free throw ability. Now the free throws are... Now free throws in this game, free throw ratings are highly respected in this game. And I mean they are highly respected because of the way the shot stick and the way that the actual cone is done. So they present that very well. So and the way it's done. Go-to guy. Certain plays. Now with the dynamic DNA, and it was still implemented in NBA Elite, and the way it was utilized, certain plays, Durant would be the one that I'd be called upon in the game. So he'd be the actual go-to guy and be the focal point of the offense in a lot of plays. I did something pertaining to plays per team, and they are all completely different by how these plays are utilized and what they do. And it's mainly more for the computer as well when they call plays. So that is a good thing. Post-up shooting likelihood. He's not going to post up a lot. Durant is more of a perimeter player. But that is the good thing of the likelihood of when they're going to post up. Some players are going to post up more compared to others. Post up shot success. If he does post up, he's going to make a good percentage of them. But he doesn't post up a lot. So he's pretty much on the perimeter most of the time. Dunk likelihood. determines how likely the players are going to attempt to dunk. Durant, he's not in this. He didn't attempt a lot of dunks, so he's not going to dunk a lot. He's either going to lay it up or he's going to shoot it. That's Durant. So the likelihood of him determines how likely the player will attempt to dunk. Layup ability, as you see, ability to finish close to the rim. His layup ability is off the hook, so he's going to make a lot of layups. But you got to remember, in this game, you're going to have to make the layup on your own because of that cone. Contest shots, ability to make the shot when drawing contact from the defender. Now, there's going to be a lot of contact in Elite 11, so sometimes the shot in that cone, and you have to aim it. Remember, this is all player control. There's nothing that's predetermined by you pressing a button or holding a meter. You have to do it. So that cone fluctuates, and if it's a good defender and they have a very, very good perimeter defensive rating, that contest shot, the contest shot does come into play. So when it being 80, when he's drawing contact, he has an 80% chance, and that's what it looks like that he'll make the shot. Hands. The player would not turn the ball over while holding it. So he doesn't have real good hands. He does turn the ball a lot over. It's only an 81, but at the same time, Durant is a shooter, so he's not going to do too much. But that fluctuates as time goes on. That's just now. But I like that rating. Offensive rebounding. Again, like I said, they took this out. They took out the defensive rebounding in the other lives, which I don't understand because the rating system is too simplified. And to this day, I don't understand why they do it. But that's his offensive rebounding ability. His offensive rebounding ability is nice. Post moves. He got moves in the post. When he does get in the post, ability to move quickly and effectively in the post with the ball. Y'all sure it's pretty much self-explanatory. Pass ability. The likelihood to pass will reach his intended receiver on target. Now, this is the thing that's baffling in Elite 11. Now, passing in this game, it does go to the particular player. You don't have a lot of like bad passes that's in the game, but they don't go fast enough. And when you pass the ball, the ability does showcase on the ability of those particular players. Oh, it does. You actually see it. So this rating really does stick. Dribbling, this stick as well, even though it doesn't have signature dribble styles, but it has basic dribbling techniques and basic dribbling moves. But the ability to dribble and for you to get those moves out quickly are really emphasized in this game. And off-ball awareness, you already know, ability to recognize scoring opportunities on the floor. One thing I would say that they took out this game was hot and cold zones. They did take it out, but the ability and the awareness to know when to score and take advantage to score is a good thing. And last but not least, which is the one that everybody likes to know about, this fast break anticipation. Ability to anticipate a fast break situation and react. Now, the leveling on this, when it comes down to the defensive anticipation and the offensive anticipation, is pretty much almost not balanced because they don't have a defensive anticipation. They just have fast break. So the fast break anticipation is pretty much mainly on the offensive end. Now, I'm thinking that mainly if they are on the defensive end, does it go over to the defensive end, the higher of the level or the better the player on what side of the ball they're on. But I think Durant, and I think it carries over for both. And I'm still critiquing that with both sides. But this is very intriguing because when they go on a fast break, they go on a fast break. When you play defense, certain players do get back and they anticipate that fast break a lot. So, and there's still more work to be done with it. So, so that's how it's simplified with these ratings. And they don't have a lot of ratings in here because it's so simplified. So I'm going to shut my mouth. Y'all put your comments down there. Y'all let me know after y'all look at some of the other stuff that's in the video. I'm going to showcase what was actually in NBA Live 07, 08, and 09. And you will see how in-depth the rating system was back before they changed it from NBA Live 10 to now. Because they simplified it and they started to go away from it. And then when you got the 14, 15, 16, and so forth, They changed it so much and they simplified it, which I don't understand why. To me, I think it's being lazy. And they just didn't want to do the in-depth rating system. But this is something that needs to come back, the ones I am about to show. Now, I know it's backwards, but I know I should have went in order. But I'm going to showcase 10, and then y'all can see how everything regressed. And it's just going to go from lowest to highest. So this is NBA Live 10 and where you're seeing the ratings. So you see max speed, you see agility, you see vertical, you see conditioning, you see strength, then you see defensive rebounding. Right after that, you're going to see on-ball defense. Right after that, you're going to see shot block. Then right after that, you're going to see steal. And then defensive post. Now, some of these, they took out or they changed them in elite. You got outside shooting likeness. You have mid-range shooting likelihood. You got free throw ability. Now, remember, they don't have two different. They have two different. They only have one category, not two. You got clutch. You got hands on perimeter. You got layup dunk frequency. You got standing dunk. You got layup ability. You got contact shots. You got hands in post. You got offensive rebounding. Offensive post and hustle, pass ability and dribbling, and then you have on ball awareness. So again, some of these that were in Live 10, they changed them and did not put them in NBA Elite. And when you look at the significance of this, you see how they changed it and then how they regressed on the rating system, especially with the dynamic DNA. And this is where I said where they were trying to change everything, starting with NBA Live 10. So you actually see that. So if you go to 10 and then you go to Elite, sorry that I started with Elite first, on which I should have did, which I shouldn't have did, but I'm showing y'all starting off with Elite and showcasing what Elite had and then showcasing what NBA Live 10 had. When you're looking at the ratings per in the categories, which is very head scratching, which is baffling because you know how much of the regression that they've done with it, and it really didn't make any sense for them to really go that low. I mean, really start to change it that much. So, hey, it is what it is. That is the direction that EA decided to go, and go from there. You can see the significant difference from Elite in Live 10. Now we're going to go where I stated at the beginning, where Live 07, 08, and 09, where the rating system was introduced with the best rating system, where it was fully in depth, and then they truly regressed. So we got 7, 8, and 9 with these, and then you had 10 and then Elite. So this is the first one. As you're reading, if y'all want to pause it, you actually can. I'm not going to go ahead and read it off. But it started off with attributes with athleticism. You see the speed, the agility, acceleration, quickness, lateral movement, recovery quickness, vertical, conditioning, strength, first step, dribble speed, and post strength. Then we got outside abilities. You got outside shooting likelihood, outside shooting ability, mid-range shooting likelihood, mid-range shooting ability, free throw ability, shooting touch ability, clutch ability, shooter's mentality, hands on perimeter, and triple threat for effectiveness. Then you add inside game. Now, if y'all want to pause it, y'all can actually do it, but you see how in depth it really is. All right, you can read that and read it for yourself and go on because it is so deep. And y'all see how much they regressed in a rating system and how deep it was. Next, you have defense. So these are all the ratings for defense. And this is how deep and in depth NBA Live was before they start to regress. And when you look at the other NBA Lives, the newer ones like 16, 18, and 19, they're really regressed. Then you have teamwork, which is the last one. So you got mental toughness, you got hustle, go-to guy, court vision, pass accuracy, difficult pass ability,
dribbling, double team composure, setting screens, using screens, off-ball awareness, and fast break anticipation. So they brought back the fast break anticipation, and that's what they brought back and put it in Elite, because they took it out of Live 10 and then they put it back in Elite. But these were the ones that were in NBA Live prior, and those are the ones that they took out, and they took out so much. So gladly put your comments down and discuss this among yourselves. Tell me how you feel about that. And I know it's a little bit head scratching and very demoralizing because of what EA has done to the franchise. So again, let's go ahead again before I close out. Remember, I went backwards. So it should start with NBA Elite, Live 10, and then 7, 8, 9, 10. Or it should go with 9, 8, 7, and it goes down. So I started with Elite first, then 10, and then back. So that way y'all will see exactly where it started from the beginning, and then how much they regressed, ending up with NBA Elite 11. And you should already know with the new future titles and what it is now. Well, I'm about to get up on out of here. I appreciate y'all coming on in. If you know, you know. But if you didn't know, your boy Prime always going to bring it to you. NBA Live all the time. And make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also hit that like button. And make sure, if you need to get to the playlist for all this, gladly. It's in the description box, or also is in the right hand annotation as well. All right, y'all. Make sure y'all hit me up on Twitter as well. All right, y'all. I'm out of here. Peace.